historical perspective on the art of violin playing since the beginning of the recording era. Jascha Heifetz, Part 4. That suave, charming performance was of a Ponces Estrelita, recorded by Jascha Heifetz in 1928. This piece was the last which Heifetz recorded before a six-year interruption of any recording activity due to the Great Depression. Despite the worldwide economic crisis, however, Heifetz's concert activity continued to be as intensive as ever. He concertized around the globe and also played in Soviet Russia, and that remained his only return to his native country. In 1934, when Heifetz came back to the recording studio, his contribution to posterity was enormous. Thanks to great progress in recording techniques, recorded sound became immensely improved, more natural and alive, and relatively clean of surface noises. And what was also important, it was now possible to record the lengthy compositions on disc. To name only a few, concerti by Mozart, Glazunov, Wieniawski, Vieuxtemps, and Sibelius were recorded by Heifetz in 1934 and 1935. In the same years, three sonatas for violin solo by Bach were recorded. In 1937, concerti by Tchaikovsky and Brahms were engraved in discs. Also on the list of Heifetz recordings of this period were Ronda Capricciosa in Havanese by Saint-Saëns, Zigeunerweisen by Sarasate, Caprices No. 13, 20, and 24 by Paganini, sonatas by Strauss, Brahms, Fauré, Franck, and still more. Here is an interesting critique of Heifetz's art given by Walter Wilson Cobbett from Grove's Dictionary of Music. He is not what is known as a temperamental player, his aspirations being toward an art entirely free from exaggeration, but nothing more subtle in expression or more perfectly balanced has been heard than his interpretations of the works which the great masters have written for the violin. Listen now to the Impromptu No. 3 in G major by Schubert, transcribed and played by Heifetz. This recording was made in 1934. That was the impromptu number 3 in G major by Schubert, transcribed and played by Jascha Heifetz in 1934. In the 1930s, the style of Heifetz playing, so angelic in his early years, changed substantially. Although his facial expression remained the same, immovable, cold, and mask-like, the intensity of his playing reached cosmic heights. At times, it even seemed as if his violin might collapse under such intense and demonic force. We will now hear the first movement of the Violin Concerto No. 4 by Vieuxtemps, written in the romantic style of 19th century tradition. Jascha Heifetz and the London Philharmonic, conducted by Sir John Barbirolli, recorded in 1935. Thank you. That was the first movement of the Violin Concerto No. 4 for violin in orchestra by Vieuxtemps, recorded by Jascha Heifetz in 1935. At the end of the 1930s and the beginning of 1940s, Heifetz made several recordings of chamber music with Arthur Rubinstein, Emmanuel Fuhrmann, and William Primrose. In 1937, the unique team of Jascha Heifetz and Arthur Rubinstein made an historical recording of Cesar Franck's Sonata for Violin and Piano. The palette of colors, the dynamic and emotional range, from extremely gentle to heroically intensive, are incredible. And now we shall present the third movement of the Sonata for Violin and Piano by Cesar Franck, Jascha Heifetz and Arthur Rubinstein in a 1937 recording.
Thank you.
That was the third movement of the Sonata for Violin and Piano by Cesare Franck, played by Heifetz and Rubinstein in a 1937 recording. Heifetz made a great number of transcriptions for the violin and piano, and one of the most popular is Hora Staccato, the fast, firing Romanian dance written by the Romanian composer Ginicu and transcribed for violin and piano by Heifetz. Listen now to a dazzling performance of this piece by Jascha Heifetz in a 1937 recording. That was Hora Staccata by Ginicu, transcribed and played with such sparkling brilliance by Jascha Heifetz in a 1937 recording. This concludes the fourth part of our program dedicated to the greatest violinist of the 20th century, Jascha Heifetz. Today's program is part of a series of programs entitled An Historical Perspective on the Art of Violin Playing Since the Beginning of the Recording Era. My name is Yuri Beliavsky, and I wish you a very good day.